What's up, scavengers, and Scandinavia here. And in this video, we're going to look at some rather interesting insects. But before that, a small update on my ant colonies. All of my ants are in hibernation, and they're all kept in my underground basement, or food storage, where temperatures don't drop below freezing and stay at about 5 degrees Celsius. I will make an update video of them sometime in March, when I bring them out of hibernation. Also, I have an Instagram now. Go check it out! There, I will post topics, too small to make a video on, and also small updates on all of my animals. Now, back to the video topic, mantids. Mantids are some really interesting creatures. Not as cool as ants, but very close. I recommend everybody getting one of these beauties, because they are so entertaining, especially now when all ants are in hibernation. I currently have 3 mantids. They are all housed in temporary setups. I will make proper housing for all 3 in the future. 2 of my mantids I moved to a bit larger setups because the box they came in was far too small. Sadly, I did not do the same with the 3rd one, simply because the box I got it in was large enough at the time. Now, however, it has molted and is in need of a temporary upgrade. I'm going to build a setup exactly like this, as I did for my other mantids. For this, you will need a box. I'm using a Good Morgon box from IKEA. Then you will need a mesh, and you will need a glue gun and 2 rubber bands. Simply cut out the mesh and glue it over the hole in the box. If your box doesn't have a hole, like mine does, simply drill some holes, and then you don't need the mesh. However, as I said earlier, this is only a temporary setup, so I will move them again. I really don't want to destroy this acrylic box with drilling in it. When the mesh is glued on, I took some metal meshing and glued it on the roof. The reason being, when mantids molt, they often hang upside down for an easier escape of their old skin. So this metal mesh gives her a space to do so. Then I add a stick and it's done. Close the box with the rubber bands so it is secure. Now let's take a closer look on my mantids. The first one I'm going to show you is from the species Poppa spursa. This one is my favorite. You can hardly see it because of its amazing camouflage. I mean, it looks so much like a stick. Also, it is rather strong considering size. And have you noticed its super short legs? They are so cute. This mantis is also referred to as the African twig mantis, because it looks like a twig and comes from Africa. This one is a female. Female mantids often grow much larger than the males. So I would suggest getting a female. All of my mantids I own currently are females. An adult Poppa spursa, this mantis, reaches about 7 centimeters, so it doesn't grow that large. However, it is still awesome. Here's a feeding clip of it. As you can see, it's acting pretty shy in the beginning, and it took about 7 minutes for it to catch the cricket. Damn, look at those awesome eyes! This is truly an apex ambush predator. Now, let's move over to the largest of my mantids, the Pseudumpsa pinopavonis. I hope I pronounced that right, it's a real tongue twister. It's actually more commonly referred to as the peacock mantis. This mantis originates from Asia and is a really interesting species. From afar, it doesn't look like much, but when threatened, it will show its wings, and then you will truly see its beauty. My mantis, however, I believe have not evolved wings yet, but it will surely do in its next molt. Can you see that black spot on its abdomen? Can anyone tell me what it is? It was there when I bought it, I hope it's not a disease. It's kinda shiny compared to the rest of its body, and it's situated on a really weird spot. Thanks for any help I can get. Sadly, I don't have any feeding clips of this girl, simply because she was too slow at fetching her meal. It took 40 minutes to wait, and then I simply gave up. She got her meal though, since it was gone half an hour later. I'm housing her in a bit larger setup, because I ran out of Good Morgon boxes from IKEA, and that she is actually much larger than the other 2 girls. Now, let's check out the first mantis I ever got, a Myomantis caffra. This species originates in South Africa. My mantis is pretty tiny compared to the other two I have. However, it is only because of age and not the species. And here is a feeding clip. This girl is really fast catching her meals, and she got this one in about 2 minutes. She has actually already evolved wings, whilst the other one hasn't. I hope you too will get a mantis like me, and if you're thinking about it, tell me what species. But also, if you already have a mantis, do the same thing and tell me what species you have. I'm really curious. Tell me in the comments below. As I said before, be sure to check out my Instagram called ants_Scandinavia. But now for the fun part, naming. What should we name these beauties? Tell me your suggestions in the comments, and I will have a poll in the next video. If you can, suggest some human-like name, such as Henry, for example. It gives them a bit more personality, and also I don't mind if it's a boy name or a girl name. But actually, it's all totally up to you, scavengers. So go wild, name your suggestions in the comments. Thanks for watching, and I will see you, scavengers, next time. Bye!